presents this unabridged recording of Make It Happen, Manifest the Life of Your Dreams, written and read by Jordanna Levin. This book is dedicated to my beautiful mama. I let you think you were helping me write a different dedication so that I could surprise you with this one. Hashtag tricked ya. The names of all the individuals in this book have been changed to save them and me from awkward run-ins at the supermarket. First, a confession. The word manifestation used to make me cringe. It wasn't so much the word itself as the blank stares, brow raises, and eye rolls it would elicit when uttered. Manifestation is not woo-woo, I'd quickly retort when it came up in conversation, as if the reputation of the entire concept rested solely on my shoulders. But I teach manifestation, so it is a big part of the work I do in the world. And everything I have in my life is a result of either a conscious or subconscious manifestation on my part, as is so for all of us. So I guess, in a way, its reputation is my business. For years when explaining what I do and what I teach, I'd dance around using the word at all. I'd replace it with phrases like creating the life you want, directing your energy, and designing your future. But it seemed silly to use a jumble of self-help words when I could use one perfectly good word. So I tidied up my spiel, I mastered my delivery, I broke the concept down, reworked it, and took full ownership of it. And once I decided I was ready to embrace the M word, I got curious about the misinterpretation of it over the years. How had manifestation become so mystical and out of reach? Turned out the negative reactions weren't so much about the name. It was the way the concept had been packaged and sold to us for the past few decades that was the real issue. You see, current teachings around manifestation make big promises and wrap them up in spiritual fluff and an esoteric bow, but they rarely deliver. And a surefire way to tarnish a concept is to have people all over the world failing to manifest their dream life after being told that all they need to do to achieve it is simply believe they can have it. It's a nice thought, but it's just that, a thought. It's unrealistic to think that's all it takes. If living the good life was as easy as thinking the good thoughts and feeling the good feels, don't you think we'd all be driving around in sports cars and working remotely from idyllic beachside bungalows by now? Where's my Mongolian yurt in the highlands next to my chicken coop and garden of homegrown vegetables? Where's my sexy farmer in his country road turtleneck and timberlands? I'm not getting any younger, and neither is he. For the uninitiated, manifestation is essentially about taking ownership of your future. Full stop. Period. It's about waking up to the fact that you are the creator of every single thing in your life. Things are not happening to you. You are making them happen, most likely unconsciously. Controversial, I know, but every one of us has the ability to be our own decision maker. And before you interrupt me with examples of events, people, and situations that you are 100% certain you didn't make happen, I urge you to stick with me and keep turning the pages of this book. Once you can wrap your head around this one thing, no matter how uncomfortable, the game changes. Although my crystal collection would have you green with envy, my wardrobe looks like it's straight out of a bohemian dream Pinterest board, and I could give you an eerily accurate reading with my third generation deck of Rider-Waite tarot cards, I'll be the first to admit that the spiritual cloak manifestation has been swanning around town in has damaged its credibility. It's not seen as a tool that is accessible to everyone, which it most certainly is. Let me be clear. I'm not here to take the spirit out of manifestation. I just want you to know that it doesn't require all of the woo-woo adornments in order to work. The teachings in this book can be understood and applied by everybody. You, your ultra-pragmatic dad, your skeptical sister, and your yoga-loving, mung bean-eating cousin. The whole motley crew. I grew up with a hippie for a mother, and a corporate powerhouse for a father. I inherited my mother's imagination and my father's practicality. I've devoured the spiritual teachings of manifestation gurus like Esther Hicks, Wayne Dyer, and Mike Dooley. I've been fascinated by the scientific approach to manifestation offered by Dr. Joe Dispenza and the humorous lab experiments introduced by Pam Grout. I love science and reason just as much as I value creativity, humor, and spirituality. And it's because of my ability to see all sides that I think you're really going to enjoy what I have to share and the way in which I'm going to share it. But I warn you, I am partial to a pop culture reference, a randomly interjected hashtag, and shortening words just for the fun of it. Hashtag soz. But my intention is to lighten the mystery around what it means to manifest, remove the stigma of practicing it, and inject a bit of humor and humanness into it. Manifestation is not a massive spiritual undertaking. It's a little shift in perspective and energy expenditure. If you've opened this book as a skeptic, don't worry, you're safe here. If you've jumped in as a believer, you may just find a different way to apply what you already know to be true. And if you fall anywhere between these two categories, you're still in for a deliciously enjoyable ride. This book is not your average manifestation book, but it is most definitely a book about manifestation. And yes, some of it is a little spiritual, but it's also practical, digestible, relatable, achievable, manageable, and if you're cool with me tooting my own horn, it's going to change the way you live your life. But please understand that I'm not promising magic, millions, or mansions, sorry, although anything is possible. I also can't guarantee that manifesting what you want will be easy, quick, or effortless. Wait, don't go, it'll be worth it, and guess what? There's no big secret to any of this. In fact, I'm going to tell you everything I know about the theory and the practice of manifestation. You will walk away incredibly self-empowered with the ability to make significant changes in your life. And there are lots of happy side effects too. You'll probably sleep better, work more efficiently, have more dollars in the bank, and fewer unnecessary stresses in your life. Not to mention bucket loads of self-confidence and self-worth. You'll most likely be a better lover, friend, sibling, and parent. Honestly, you'll be a more enjoyable human in general. If all of this isn't enough to make you want to keep turning the pages of this book, then perhaps you're not ready to take control of your life just yet. And that's cool. You can come back when you are. I hope you do, because this shit works. Let me tell you a little story. Growing up, I thought I was psychic. I would think things, and then they would come true. But I wouldn't just think them. I would feel them, worry about them, take subconscious action towards them, and believe with every cell of my body that my future predictions were inevitable, which ultimately guaranteed that they were. A broken foot, a cancelled flight, a crooked business deal, a tragic love story. The list went on and on. What I eventually realized, just in time to prevent me from whipping out a crystal ball, headscarf, and flashing neon sign, was that I wasn't predicting the future. I was manifesting it. The energy I was expelling through stress, anxiety, and worrying about the future was making these unfortunate things materialize. So one day, I changed the game. After several shoulder dislocations, a disastrous job, another failed relationship, and many a pity party, I put on my researcher's hat and took a good look at what was really going on. If I could manifest this shitstorm of negative stuff, perhaps I could manifest the things I actually wanted. Turned out I could. Instead of exerting all my energy on negative and fruitless untruths, I deliberately focused my energy on creating a positive, rewarding, and abundant life. And I believe wholeheartedly, without a doubt, that you can too. It wasn't easy. It took a lot of trial and error, and I had to rework a lot of old concepts and look at them through a different lens. Many times I'd get close to cracking the secret, only to find my manifestation slipping through my fingers. Consequently, I'd feel depressed, deprived, and like an utter failure. And that right there was the catalyst to finding the answers to manifestation that I'd not fully explored yet. Failure. It rocks our self-worth, self-love, and our self-trust. When we fail and feel defeated, we give up and we walk away. And if you're anything like me, we rebel against the very thing we were trying so hard to achieve. This is how I came to develop the manifestation equation, a foolproof way to manifest anything you desire. Now, I'm no mathematician. In fact, I still giggle at the fact that I've bundled these teachings into an equation, but that really is the best way to explain them. Successful manifestation comes down to simple mathematics. So simple that even this numbers dummy can understand it. Like any basic maths equation, the manifestation equation is the sum of its parts. If you exclude or ignore one part of the equation, the whole thing falls apart. And trust me, I've tried every variable of this equation imaginable. Before we dive into the equation itself, I think it's important to share the power that the manifestation equation has wielded in my life and in the lives of my mentoring clients and event attendees. Using this equation, I've been able to manifest $20,000 not once, but twice. I've also manifested a new car, my ideal clients, sell-out events, unbelievable business opportunities, great parking spots in the busiest of beachside suburbs, free tuition, all expense paid holidays, and this book that you're reading now. My event attendees have manifested dream jobs, soulmates, babies, so many babies, large sums of money, holidays, property, meaningful connections, and many more wonderful things. But it's important at this point, before we get further in this book and into the manifestation equation, that you understand that none of these things that have been manifested are due to luck. I didn't win a car, I manifested the means to buy one. I didn't find $20,000 in a briefcase on the sidewalk. I manifested job opportunities that were worth that exact sum of money. The manifestation equation isn't a mystical mantra or magical spell. It's a self-empowerment tool that, when used correctly, enables you to create anything you damn well want. And here's the thing. It doesn't matter whether you're manifesting a new car or a parking spot. The energy you put behind it is exactly the same. Insert excited gasp here. Sound good? Right, let's do this. Part 1, the theory. Chapter 1, what is the manifestation equation? The manifestation equation is something I came up with after years of experimenting with my own manifestation practice and tweaking my approach to it. Only when I applied each of the equation's four parts to my practice did I receive the results I'd been searching for. I'll walk you through it soon enough and teach you how to apply each element of the equation to any area or situation in your life. But for now, all you need to know is that the equation goes like this. Thoughts plus feelings plus actions plus faith equals successful manifestation. Seems pretty straightforward, right? It is. This equation is based on four universal laws. We'll get to those soon. And I'll spend the first half of this book breaking this equation down for you bit by bit, so it becomes even clearer. But first, let's take a little trip down the misguided manifestation path you've most likely wandered down. We've only been sold part of the story. The danger when a concept like manifestation catches fire and becomes the spiritual it thing, as this did around the mid-1990s, is that it can get watered down and oversimplified in the process of being packaged up for a mass market with a limited attention span. This was definitely true of Poor Manifestation, and it emerged from its moment in the spotlight, a shadow of its former self. So even if you think you're familiar with the concepts and practices of manifesting, I'm going to ask you to put those ideas to one side until you've finished this book. You might find the recipe you've been sold is not the whole story. Not by a long way. The Law of Attraction.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.